Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. Now, I wonder what game this says I'm going to be playing. It's probably going to be... This will probably actually say Doom, which is pretty funny. Because it always seems like two games behind. Like two broadcasts behind what I'm actually doing. Okay, cool. We're looking like we're live. Yep. We're live. Right. Let's, tweet the shindig out. Right. NG2 and... No, it says I'm playing Halo 5 for some reason. I fucking hate Twitter. Right, let's do this. Oh yeah, Garja Brawl. That's it. That's where I called it last time. I'm really surprised this save didn't corrupt. I checked this. Well, I think it was a couple of weeks ago now, actually, when I set up the 360 again. And yeah, I fully expected this to have corrupted because it crashed when I saved. Like the whole thing just crashed. So I'm really happy it didn't though, because this has been on my backlog for like the last 8 years, pretty much. I've been meaning to do this. Like, I've been meaning to do another mentor playthrough and actually get all the weapons for a successive play. And I have never done this. So, this is very, very long overdue, you might say. Oh yeah, Shadow Ninja time. Garja Brawl. Let's do this. We got the Windmill Shuriken out. Yep. Nope. Oh, that was close. That tail whip still hurts, even though it's only on mentor. You do not want to get hit by that thing. Oh, that actually killed him. You tried to get me there, didn't you, you little bastard? Whoa, that was actually really lucky. That looked like that should have hit me. You bastard. I love how they actually gave you, like, guard-breaking abilities in this. Like, you can actually break the guard on enemies now, not the other way around. Not just the other way around. That's what that towards X move is really good at doing. It's powerful as hell, too. It's kind of a broken move, really. Like, the talons in this game are pretty overpowered, really. Like, that move right there, like, its de-limbing ability is insane. And it has, like, the actual, like, individual damage of the move is pretty good, too. Oops. God, that sound is so cool. Oh, don't you dare try and tail whip me, son! That was sick. I actually got a Izuna drop from just in-air X. Oh, I still remember the game. Yeah, I still remember the strings. But the talons actually have some really long, like, really long-winded strings. Shake that blood off. Right, what we got? 17k. I've got 1 and 2 of them. Weapons. I don't really need to upgrade my dragon sword. No, I don't really need to upgrade anything. No, I'll save my money. What's the test of valor coming up? Well, yeah, I'm really glad I didn't buy one now. I know there's a test of valor coming up, but I can't remember what's in it, so I'm probably just gonna skip it. Oh! Bitch. That was not cool. He jumped through my UT. Test of Valor's this way. Holy shit. What's in here? Oh! Really? Oh, piss off. I was really hoping that would still be a UT. That made no sense. Right, give me a health orb. Please. Arsehole. Yeah, there's a test of valor down there, but I can't remember which one it is. No, I did not want to do that. God, I love that OT. Nah, son. Don't try and tail whip me. What is this way? Hang on. What? Oh, I can't remember. Whoa! More dudes! I still get nervous every time they tail whip because it has just the most insane hitbox on it. The thing that big thing that separates them though, like there, right? He tried to do that. That string right there is when they do their tail whip. But if you block it, these guys don't do their tail whip. And if they whiff, they don't do their tail whip. What makes the red guard just so goddamn broke is that they do their tail whip whatever happens. Like, whether you block it, whiff it, they do not care. They will always tail whip. And on Master Ninja, that thing hurts. You're dead. Shit, I should have absorbed that. That was UT'd essence. I need the money. Countered. Oh, yeah, got my counter first go. I still got it. Oh, yeah, I remember now. This is, yeah, the key. Forget him. I don't know if you actually have to come down here, though. You probably do. I never noticed those candles just there. Oh, I remember. I think there's a skull in that room. On a first playthrough, I'm pretty sure there's a skull in that room. That's why you have to go in there. Right. Do these have... Yeah, they do. Can't remember their wall attack. Yeah, I can't remember what that test of valor is, so I'm not going to do it, because it might be one that's just super boring. And to be fair, most of them are super boring, so I'm not really going to do those. Wait, we got our heal. Let's put in a save. Because you can die very quickly in this game. I think it's dogs and something. I want to say it's definitely either dogs and something or werewolves and something. But I can't remember what the other enemy is. So, and I'm a little too rusty to fight that many dogs. Oh, can I just skip these guys? Hang on, do these even attack me? Yeah. Oh, I love the windmill shuriken. Whoa! Would you go away? I knew that was going to hit me. I love that you can actually, on landing, like, out of hit frames, though. Yeah, where's your arm? Where's your face? Get down here. Thank you. Get wrecked. Hey, NG2 Ryu. How are you? Am I going the right way? God, it's been so long since I've played this game. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I am going the right way. That's a herb. Yep. Alright, so we've got Wolf coming up relatively soon, I think. There's not a whole lot of this left. Or is there? I don't actually remember. It doesn't help that last time I played this was a couple of months ago. I think it was at least a couple of months ago. Oh no, I'm thinking of the wrong chapter. This is the water dragon, isn't it? Oh shit, I hate this boss. How am I doing for items? Okay, I'm doing good, but yeah, I do not like this boss. Right, I need the bow and arrow and the scythe, I think. Please be something good. Oh, I can't remember this guy's attacks. Let's take a second. I remember that. I remember that being really cheap. I know there's a delay on this. Oh, wow, that actually didn't hit me. No, I don't want to get in the water. Really not sure what that is supposed to do. Wait, there we go. That's some good damage. Yeah, that attack always used to piss me off. Whoa, that was good damage too. I think it is pretty much just scythe UTs for this guy. I know he's one of the few bosses you can OT as well. Wow, I thought the iframes would carry over for that. Right, that's gonna... That'll give me enough time for another one. There's my timing. Oh yeah, that's the OT, isn't it? Oh, come on. One more arrow. There we go. He's dead. God, that boss fight is so shit. Yeah, chapter 6 is Wolf, I think. Huh. Master Ninja without doing the Fiend Challenge, really? I'm surprised by that. Very surprised. Oh, God, I hate the load times on this game. That was one of my biggest disappointments with this game. I still think it's really, really good, but the boss fights were such a downgrade from NGB. The boss fights in this game are kind of... They're some of the worst parts of the game. There's not many that are... I think... I'd say Genshin is probably the only boss fight that actually feels, you know... polished. Like, he's the only one that's sort of semi-consistent and, like, well-designed. For the most part, the boss fights are terrible. Right, how am I doing for money? 27k, that's not great. Oh yeah, that doesn't work anymore, does it? Yeah, it's like the one foolproof way to fight Ghostfish. And they were like, oh no, we'll take that out in the sequel. We'll make it so that there is no foolproof way to fight them, and you cannot avoid taking damage. Oh, shit. I've been playing too many games where you automatically climb onto shit. I've been playing a lot of Halo, and I've been playing a lot of Doom. I remember the first time I played through this game, it took me ages to realize where you had to go in this room. And I mean ages. I was running around here for a good half an hour trying to find out, trying to figure out where to go. There we go. I know there is... What's in here? Is it Talisman? Yes. I know it's worth going in there. There is a shitload of fish you can kill in here, but there's not really any point. I swear that looks a lot faster than it is in NGB. Oh, I do miss the roll. I'm a roll person. Alright, we'll swap over to the Dragon Sword. See? That's usually an immune string. What the hell am I doing? I know that happens too. Get off me. Fucking fish. I mean, they don't do quite as much damage as they used to do to you in Black, but I mean, they still hit pretty damn hard, considering, you know, as I said, there is no safe way to kill them in this game, other than just, you know, fire up a Nimpo. I think that's most of them gone. There we go. Don't need anything from Muramasa. Nope. More fish. We got Gorgeous coming up. Is there anything back here? More fish. Ah, yeah, I thought there was something back here. Cool. Let's go back to Talons. I do love the Talons. Be careful here. I'm going to fall off again. Gorges. Goodbye. Oh, shit! Get off me. And that too, like, it takes you a lot longer to mash out of attacks in this game. Like, there's a lot of, like, the amount of guaranteed damage enemies deal to you is just a little bit too much in this game. Like, it was a lot more balanced than the first one. Right, more fish. God, I love that UT. What's that, Nimpo? Yeah. Close. If I remember rightly, I don't think you can actually just run off the edge, which is very, very handy. Oh, what we got in here? Isn't this, yeah, this is Gorges again. Oh, we got red Gorges. We had a red Gorger. Yep, I can still time that. It's a really important thing when you fight Gorge, is you've got to be able to like time the UT to hit them when they land on their tail whip. That's kind of an important thing in every NG game, really. Like, if you release your UT too early, it whiffs, and if you wait too long, they'll hit you. I hate it when that happens. Have some of that. See, look, they don't just do their tail whip willy-nilly. I love that with that kick up, that's well good. Whee! Awesome. I'm gonna put that on I have got a life upgrade, sweet. And a Spirit of the Devils that I didn't know I had. Shit! What am I doing? I should have saved that until I had. Oh wow, did I not even pick up Piercing Void Nimpo on this playthrough? Jesus. Now, for the life of me, can't remember where that is, but. So I guess I won't be picking it up on this one either. Right, let's heal. You need to equip your talismans, don't you? There we go. Just in case some unsafe shit happens. Oh god, this boss fight is crap. I usually just use a scythe, I think, for this one. Oh god, I remember this fight on a Karma run too. It's just, Jesus Christ. It is a shame that Karma running never caught on for this game. A shame, but at the same time, you know, totally understandable. Money, 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 money. Yeah. Whoa, look at that frame rate. Look at that frame rate. It does not like it. He does not like that. I can't remember if this is a boss you can OT either. I don't think he is. What level am I, Oh shit, they're only level 1. Whoops. How did that miss, like, the vast majority of that group? They've got a lot of range on their attack, despite what it looks like as well. It's really annoying. See? You sometimes think you're out of the way of it, and it just clips you. It's really irritating. Go away. Right, is that it? Pretty sure that's it, but I'm not. That's the flails. What's my Kusari Gama at? That's level 2. That's not the full rotate Y though, is it? I love that the side's got the flying swallow, that's cool. Oh, come on. Trigger this bloody fight already. There we go. If I remember, it's Windblades. Okay. Oh, this is actually... it's an annoying attack, but it is pretty funny. Ow. I don't remember this guy all too well. I know that's got a... just an absolutely absurdly big hitbox. Oh, this frame rate is unreal. Whoa, I thought that was gonna hit me. Ah, damn it, that's what I needed as well. Ooh, that was close. Son of a bitch. Get the fuck off me. I'm not gonna argue, but that definitely should have hit me. Come on, get stunned. God, I hate that move. Yes, he's stunned. All right, we'll just nimpo. Oh, that's why you have your talisman equipped. God, that hurt. I knew there was a reason I should have upgraded my swords, and this boss fight was it. That's fine. You notice how, like, this entire boss fight's been at, like, probably fucking 10 frames a second as well. It doesn't help. Right. That's all she wrote. Goodbye. God, that is such a shit boss. Ironically enough, the easiest way to kill him is with the nimpo I don't have. You just piercing, like, when you stun him, if you just piercing void his orb in his chest, like, it virtually kills him. Even on Master Ninja, like, it does just a shitload of damage. Where's my talons? There they are. That was good for money, though. I got a good, like, what, I think 30k out of that fight. Okay, that's some serious upper body strength. Boom! And you all fall down. I should kill those. Ooh, that was close. Nah, 3 out of 4 is not bad. I just can't be bothered to farm these guys. There is a shitload of money in these skeleton dudes. These guys keep spawning for ages. But I don't care. Shit. It's kind of the risk you take. You can spend the time and kill them all, and then you can get over there no problem, or you can just try the quick way. But the quick way didn't work. So we'll do it the boring way. I do wish you could actually over, like, you know, out-prioritize his auto-targeting with the direction. You can in black to a certain extent, but just not on certain moves. Really? Ryu. You never change. Nope. There we go. Right, I think it's Werewolf City now. Which is good, because they give you a lot of money. God, that, look at that frame rate. That is so bad. I mean, Jesus, man. Look at that, look how... That is horrendous. It's still really... It's because it's still tracking those, like, beetle things. Because there's no actual, like, encounter proximities like there was in black. It just tracks enemies continuously. Okay, cool. That's given me a grain and a elixir back. What's up, Muramasa? Oh, hey, Easy Jones. Oh, I'm glad. Thank you. I appreciate the compliment. Right, what are we going to upgrade? Swords, maybe? Nah, swords or Tonfer I don't need. Dragon Sword I don't really need. That could be one. Hey, Skeeth, how's it going? Nah, I don't really need those. Oh, I should... I probably should... I do love Muramasa's noises in this game. They're so good. Yeah, I should put in a save because I'm not. I haven't got talisman anymore. This game looks so, like, plain too. That's the only thing about it. Like, it doesn't look bad. Everything just looks kind of, you know, flat. Like, there's no. Yeah, where's your face? I do love the werewolves. Werewolves are fun. I really like the soundtrack in this game. I always felt that was one thing that, especially when it came out, I know obviously the graphics weren't as good, you know, like, you know, by comparison to NGB and NG04, but I really thought that this this game's soundtrack was really underappreciated. I think it's really good. X's birthday tonight. What's the scoop on that then, Skeeth? What do you mean? No, no, no. You missed. Let's swap to the Tomfoot. Boom! Ah, that's so sick. It's like almost on the fly weapon switching. Almost. It's very, very close. Is that one of the... Yeah, is that one of the arms I just delimbed? My Luna's level 3, isn't it? Whoops. Where's my Luna? There's my Luna. Yeah, my Luna's level 3. Which means we're good. Look, it's Mohawk. He thinks he's badass. Ow! Ooh, they do hurt. Oh, I see. I see. That does make sense. You missed. You could just stay here and watch these guys sponge my de-limbing moves. Oh! Where's your head? Where's your head? That sounds like a... That could be a problematic evening. I don't know about that. I think I'd definitely stay at home. Ow! That! That seriously hurt. That's like half life on Mentor. That's crazy. That's exactly what I did not want to have happen. Stop sponging this. God, man, look at the detail on those claws. That looks... that they just look so good. This bit's kind of annoying, actually. If I remember rightly. It's like dragons and... yeah. So this is the dragon bit. Stop that. And have that. Right. There we go. Let's mop up these guys first. That looks so good. Thank God you're invulnerable while you're doing OTs. The bow is like the one thing where his auto-targeting is actually quite good. You work every day, Skeeth, even the weekend? That does suck. Yeah, but I mean, look at that. His auto-targeting is actually not bad with the bow. Whoops. As I say that, he attacks the wrong guy. This is another one. There is a test of valor here. I can't remember what it is, though. I think this is a pretty good one, though. Oh, come on, Ryu. I was just saying that your targeting with the bow is pretty good. Oh man. The charged bow is so much fun. Especially against ninjas. Ow. Okay, I'm getting torn up here. Stop that. Ooh, that was close. Right, we'll try our luck, see if we can't get health up. Really? They were a lot more, I think they feel like they were a lot more stricter on that in this game. Like, being at low health doesn't kind of get virtually guarantee you a health orb like you did in NGB. Oh wow, 3 jobs, dude. That's crazy. Right. God damn it. Ooh, that was close. That looks so cool. Yeah, I'll go and save, and if it's a test of valor I actually want to do, I'll do it. If not, I won't do it. Because a lot of them on, like, above Mentor, you just get the really big, like, spongy enemies, and they're just boring as fuck. Nobody wants to play those. I certainly don't. On landing jumps, kind of useless in this game, though. You punk! But you think you're pretty good, don't you? Punching me. Nope. I love that. I love the bow so much. This game pretty much is entirely like that. You think, like, the first mission... hey, why don't... like, the first mission is... hey, why don't you fight a giant rat now? With, like, you know, windmill blades. Then the next mission is, why don't you fight a giant ninja? And then the mission after that, why don't you fight a giant, like, weird robot worm thing? The boss fights are just really... it's whatever. They kind of... I don't know, I don't want to say they made sense in the first game, because you fight some silly stuff in the first game. But they fit, at least, you know? Like, you know, thematically, they made sense. You know, it made sense why you were doing what you were doing. I'm not killing those. I can't be bothered. Right, let's spawn all you dudes. Wow, I've only got four, really? Stop it. As soon as you delim or kill them, that's when the other werewolves will start throwing stuff at you as well. So, it's always good to take down the alpha ones first. Leg, face, and I'll cut you in half for good measure. I think this next one's like a whole room full of garges. Yes, like that should look really impressive, but it doesn't. It looks like it's missing like its kind of final level of detail. It's really weird. Isn't there something down there? I want to say that there is, but I don't remember. No, turn around, Ryu. Ah, I screwed up my own landing. Okay, we've got red garges. Focus. Oh, lovely. God, this weapon is so good. You missed. Stop being funny. Stop being a wise guy. Yeah, I think that as well. Like, I mean, the first game, I think, had a lot more time put into it. The first game, I think, took... I think the first game was at least 5 years or more it took to finish that game. This one was a lot less. Oh, you little shit. Get off me. I hate that they get four guaranteed hits before you can get them off on that attack. It's so cheap. And hit trading's really weird in this game, too. Like, it's never in your favor to actually trade a hit. Yeah, I get countered. Oh. And I always felt counters should have always guaranteed a delim. Because it can be really risky to counter in this game, because you actually have to time it properly. You can't just mash like you could in the first game. That's one thing I always thought would be really cool in NG, actually, is a counter hit system. Not anything, like, super complicated. I mean, just some, you know, something, like, akin to something like Tekken, you know. But I think that would have been really cool. Oh, I thought he had something cool. Yo, oven door. Yeah, I remember. This is my kitchen. Really? That was close. Oh, they have so much armor, it's stupid. You missed. Yeah, they have armored grabs, for fuck's sake. Like, come on. How cheap is that? At least in NGO, like, every... NGB, like, all the command grabs you could actually stuff. You know, they were... You couldn't not interrupt them. Ghostfish? No. Oh, yeah, I mustn't forget I've got that Life of the Gods upgrade. Yeah, it's just inconsistencies, really, Skeeth. It's really unfortunate. I mean, even though, you know, I'm not as big of a fan of this game, I've still put a considerable amount of time into this game, and that's kind of the bittersweetness of it. You know, it's the lack of consistency, because when this game works, it really is phenomenal. When everything works the way it's intended to, this is the best action game ever made. Like, no question. But stuff just doesn't work often enough. This ninjas. Whoa, this isn't ninjas. That's not ninjas. Right, let's get you fellows to bunch up, shall we? This is my mansion. And you guys ain't invited. Hey, lovely frame rate drop right there. Give me my money. Right, they should start throwing shit at me now. Like that. Oh, how did that miss every one of them? That was close. That just was sheer luck, really. That could have easily taken like my entire health bar. I love the kick, like the just the 360 kick just takes their head off. It's so good. Another move I don't get to use. That sucks. Right, okay, cool. We got the herb. That door is locked. So, I mean, for obvious reasons, this always reminds me of the mansion in Resident Evil 1, where you come in. Ryu, don't open that door. Ha ha ha. It's only missing, like, a couple of doors, too, when you think about it. Like, it really is only missing a couple of doors to be the mansion. What's in here? Oh, hello. The dining room. Hope this is not Chris's blood. Oh no, it's werewolf blood. It's worse. It's way worse. It's hella werewolf blood, because now they got no heads. This is my dining table. Don't put your feet on the table. It is rude. Oh, I know. Let's do this. Let's try and kill him with this. Alright, go away. God damn it. Alright, come on. Come on, I just want to get this. Stop jumping at me. Yes! There we go. Boom! Kicked his head off. That is so good. The single upgrade. Oh yeah, you only get like, isn't it, if I remember rightly, you get like one upgrade weapon. You get one weapon upgrade like per Muramasa, is that right? What? How did that make any sense? Okay, that hurt. Take that. I don't give a shit about your chairs. Oh, I want to do it again. Ooh! Ah. Boom! Ah, come on. Whoops. So, oh, God, I hate those so much. Whee! That's so funny. It's... Ooh, I just love the animation on that kick. It's so good. Hey, NBA Mist. You only need one upgrade. To be honest, you don't need any upgrades in this game. Forward Y destroys this entire game. Forward Y with the talons is ridiculously broken. Like, it really is. It's crazy. Yeah, that's true. Although, I think it was weird because they... Man, I forgot how many bloody gorges and shit there is in this level. Oh no, that's gonna hurt! Ow, ow, ow! Jesus. Alright. God, that attack is so good. Come on. Whiff. There we go. Takes care of you. Yeah, like, even the delimbing properties of Ford Y isn't changed when you upgrade the talons. Like, it's like that at level 1. It's so silly. But it's kind of necessary, really. I mean, especially in this gun. Yeah, you think I don't see that? And it's got a slight invulnerability frames, which you kind of saw just then. Take that. And that. But yeah, I think the main reason they put that in was to try and balance out the essence, because in like if you just farmed essence, you could get enough essence to like upgrade all of your weapons to max level, which was silly. But again, you know, it kind of defeats the whole point of actually playing the combat in the game, because you can't use your essence. It's stupid. Nah, I ain't risking that. There we go. I also think, like, the permanent damage system is shit, for the most part. Yeah, I mean, there's a couple of glitches you can use on Elizabeth, though, isn't there? There's the obvious flying swallow one with the flails. There's a couple of areas where she can get trapped. Oh, okay. Where am I going then? I love how all the body parts stay there though. This is where Forest is. Any Resident Evil fans get that reference? Ooh, ninjas! You're fun. Guillotine throw your ass. I love that. That animation on that final hit, God, it's so good. So good. See, those guys thought they were good. Those guys thought they were good, but they weren't. We'll save again. Yeah, it was. I think that just, that kind of sums up Sigma 2 in a nutshell, really. There were actually some good ideas to balance the game, but they, I honestly feel in more or less every way, I think they just made it worse. Like, they toned down the damage, but they also toned down your delimming ability and introduced, you know, a lot of one-hit kill moves. And, you know, it's like, yeah, you fixed a couple of things, but then you kind of screwed up everything else, so... Oh, he command-grabbed me, what a bitch. We're gonna use here, what are we gonna... Let's use the, Kusarigama. God, I love that. Oh, yeah. Boom! I do love this string. It's so long-winded. God, that's a good noise. Get that blood off my weapon. Oops. Ah, oh, this weapon is so much fun. Difficult to use, but... Oh, God! That actually crushed the grab. I've never seen that before. Counter-attacking's huge with this weapon, too. Like, you really need to be able to counter-attack consistently. Will I be doing Master Ninja mode? I mean, not tonight. I might do. But this is mainly just finishing off something that I was, like, been meaning to do for ages. I love that move. Oh, he got that out of the way of my OT. That was smart. You cheeky bitch. Get countered. Come here. That is so sick. I like how... I wish more weapons had that, though. Like, I think the Kusarigama and I think the Scythe has got one. Like, there's very few weapons that have, like, a built-in OT string that doesn't actually count as an OT. So you don't always get yellow essence from it. And that is one of the few. What we got here? But yeah, this is something I've been meaning to do for ages, Mist. It's, I always forgot to do, like, a full mentor playthrough with getting all the weapons for successive play back when I played the game. So, I thought it'd be a good way to break out the game and stream it. Because people still love to see the NG stuff. More so on YouTube, though. I've noticed that. Like, like, the MKX stuff and NG stuff, I notice that gets a lot more views on YouTube than it does Twitch. I don't know why. Maybe it could just be the time I stream. You know, I don't really have a routine or anything, so probably just look at the draw. I want my windmill shuriken back for this room, for sure. More massa. This is Ghostfish. Ah, why did they remove... Bat. That was cool. Wasn't really what I wanted to do, but... It was pretty sweet. Right, 79k. There's just no point upgrading weapons, though. Like, that's the annoying thing. Like, there's no point upgrading your swords because you get the True Dragon Sword and Blade of the Archfiend eventually. There's no point upgrading the Tonfas because the only thing you use them for is the UT. The Kusari Gama, I'll upgrade. Actually, no, not yet. I won't upgrade that just yet. I don't have a talisman yet, do I? I do like to have at least one. It's good to have the insurance, but I should be all right. He says, famous last words. Right, werewolves. No? Did I save? Yeah, I did save, didn't I? Right, let's use the Luna. What? Oh yeah, I knew there were werewolves coming. That's also one of the most broke moves in the game. For anyone that doesn't know, the last hit of the ET, like, is an instant kill on virtually every single enemy in the game. And even if it doesn't, like, it's so powerful that, you know, they're virtually dead anyway. I love the sound effects on the Luna stuff. They kept my favorite move. And it's a dealing move. Boom! No, I don't upgrade the dual swords. I just wait until I get, you know, Blade of the Archfiend and then have those. Cause they're just like, when you get those, man, like it turns those into just they're absolute powerhouse. Yeah, we got nothing but alphas in here, right? Yeah, that instant kills you. Oh, I didn't get hit by the last hit. You guys did, though. Aww. That is so... They have, like, three armored grabs. It's so stupid. I mean, look at how much health that took as well. Although, thinking about it, like, in hindsight, you are just as broke as, like, kind of a lot of this stuff in this game, in the first game. It's just what makes the first game in that way more balanced is that the enemies are nowhere near as dangerous when you know everything. Whereas in this game, doesn't matter how good you are, if you're sloppy or you get caught, like, you know, you just kind of get caught out, you can die in, you know, in just a split second. That doesn't really happen as much in the first game once you know everything. Oh, that was close. I love that. That's such a good ET. Boom. And you're invulnerable in the startup of those, which is really good. Oh, hello. I thought there was only two of you. That's still one of the best strings in the game, I think. Just XXY with the Luna. I do love that move too. Forward X. Don't try that. Get countered. Boom. That was very close. See what I mean? I got sloppy, and I almost died right there. I got floated, and that could have easily have been it. Can we be serious that hard on NGB is more difficult than Master Ninja? The enemy placement, you don't get the UF till later. I don't know about that, man. I mean, the enemy placement, I understand what you mean. But consider Chapter 1 Master Ninja versus Chapter 1 hard, you know? Like, I mean, that thing's dumb. But the thing about Master Ninja, though, and it's not something you really... Like, at least I didn't realize straight away. The only real difference on, like, NGB, and it's kind of the same on Mentor and Master Ninja, too, apart from the damage on this game. Yeah, I knew you were going to do that. Oh, you made me look stupid, though. You didn't jump into my move. Is, yeah, like, that first chapter on NGB is so much harder because you don't have... I mean, on very hard, rather, sorry. You don't have the Lunar right at the start, which is, you know, what makes it so much easier when you know. And it's the same thing on, you know, on this game, too. Like, when you know how to do the OTs and stuff and really abuse the invulnerability frames, Mentor's kind of a joke. Like, it's really, really easy compared to Master Ninja because the damage isn't there. You know, one hit on Mentor, granted, is still a hell of a lot of damage, but it doesn't virtually kill you. You know, on Master Ninja, if anything hits you in this game, you virtually have to use a, you know, a full elixir, otherwise you're dead. Think I didn't see that shit? I do love the, like, the flail effect on the Luna. Yeah, like, stuff like this would be so much harder if that wasn't just an instant kill on all of these guys. Yeah, you see, that missed this guy, so it didn't kill him. It's a weird, I don't know if it's intentional. I love this move, but it's so impractical because you get hit in it. Ow, ow, ow. But I mean, prime example, Master Ninja, like, I would be almost dead. I mean, I'm kind of almost dead now, but I mean, I'd be in, like, well into the second Nimpo slot if that had hit me on Master Ninja. Let's go put in a save because Volf can be a bit of a bitch. You've been live for long? Not really. About an hour, I think. Yeah, about an hour. Stop doing that, Ryu. Behave. There we go. What was I rambling about, anyway? The Alma fight. I don't mind the Alma fight. The Alma fight's pretty consistent. The only thing that's inconsistent on Alma's, Awakened Alma, is the Flying Swallow knockdowns. Unless you're Snare, obviously. But yeah, other than that, she's fairly consistent. But yeah, I think the comparison of Hard and Master Ninja, again, it's the difficulty jump as well. You go from, you know, Hard, which is granted, you know, quite a bit more difficult than normal, but then Very Hard is ridiculous. You know, Very Hard, you've got Vigorian ninjas in the first bloody chapter, you've got command grabs, you've got, you know, a significant bump in the amount of damage that enemies do. Fiend challenges are a lot harder, you know, bosses have much tougher minions with them. It's a big difference between Very Hard and Hard, and I think that's why Master Ninja feels a little bit less harsh in the first game. In this game, Mentor's a joke compared to Master Ninja. Like, once you've gone through Master Ninja a couple of times, Mentor is just a cakewalk. It's really, really easy. So the games kind of do have that in common, just on slightly different modes. Oh, do I have to kill these guys? Shit. I didn't buy any incendiaries either. No, there's no more Amasa, is there? I was going to reset and buy incendiaries because, God, this bit is boring. There we go. I love that you can do two and then still get a UT. That looks so sick. Oh, motherfucker. The animation on that is so good. Like, it looks real. Like, it's really weird how they managed to make that look like, you know, something that someone could actually do. These guys are okay as long as you don't actually go for UTs. If you go for UTs when you're surrounded, like, you're pretty much dead. There we go, right, fill up all my arrows. I'm probably gonna go for the Lunar, actually, on Volf. Or the Dragon Sword. My Dragon Sword is level 2, right? I think my Dragon Sword, I might want it level 3 for this. I can't remember. Oh no, I just thought, yeah, you can just wreck this guy with the Luna. Yeah, you're dead. Oh, didn't quite charge up in time. Oh, shit, I forgot how much range that thing's got. Oh, I'm dead, yeah. Yeah, I might want the level 3 dragon swords a little bit better for that, because it's just a bit more consistent. I haven't got to do many fights to get back to him. Yeah, the boss damage is kind of there on Mentor, though, as you can see. I mean, the bosses really hurt when they hit you. Especially Genshin. I think he's probably the most damaging boss in the game. Oh, I forgot, you don't have to, Oh, shit, he does that every time, doesn't he? Oh, I don't really want to waste the elixir on that. Nah, yeah, you know what? Yeah, kill me. Let's... Whoa! Are you serious? Okay, I'm actually gonna... Okay, I'm gonna test that. God, how much... The amount of damage that did. Jesus, that's like... Okay, yeah, he can kill me now. I just wanted to test that. Actually. You're dead. I forgot that the final hit of XXY can double connect, and it's broke as fuck. This is the best... One of the best fights in the whole game. I love this. Yeah, where's your faces? I just love being able to chain the Windmill Shuriken, UT. Oh, you son of a bitch. Okay. Alright. Alright. You wanna be clever? Boom. Yeah, I know how to fight Vault, man. Played this game once or twice. Oh, God, those grabs, man. Frame rate's taking a big hit. No, I didn't want you to do that. Tom for time! God, that's so sick. You can actually get a shitload of money out of this if you really want to farm it. But I just want to have a bit of fun here. That sound effect on the Tom for UTs is amazing. Boom. I don't know if anybody remembers, but I think it was originally Dark Hazuki who showed the strategy for Volf, like, really early on. It was, like, a few days after the game was out, he showed the Dragon Sword strategy. It was really, really good. So it took a while to kind of figure a lot of the bosses out, because they were they were so random that, you know, it took you a while to kind of find something that was, you know, at least semi-reliable for them. At least most of them. No, I was just about to OT him. Right, no one cares. Nimpo remaining. I only have one. Nah, whatever. Is this the... Oh, what? Is this the... I think this is the airship level next. I'm pretty sure it is, anyway. I keep forgetting I've got that Life of a Thousand Gods upgrade, too. Yeah, airship, also. The Flying Fortress. Oh, the start of this is booty. I want my talons. There we go. Damn it, I can't get that one. Ah, they got rid of my cover. I'll use that. The start of this mission is so stupid. Like, you can get what they were trying to do, but like, it just does not work. What's in that box? Oh, well, that makes sense. One more. Huh. I'm not complaining. Thank you. I can't actually remember her name. Oh yeah, I want Scythe UTs for these guys. Always block. Oh no, it's a ton for UTs, isn't it? Yeah, ton for UTs, instant kill these guys. All you gotta do is take off both their arms. Because even though it like it does actually count as a D-limb, you can't, like, the regular D-limbing properties don't apply to these guys, which is really stupid. Because otherwise they're just kind of tanks. Ooh, cheeky. Yeah, UT takes him down too. It's really important to stay airborne as well on these guys. Like, they can lock you down really, really well with the machine gun fire. Right, let's buy some shit. I'll buy one of them. I'll only buy one of those. Yeah, I don't really need anything. I think it's mostly ninjas in this level. At least from what I remember. Oh, damn it. Boom! Aw. Oh. Come on, line up. I want you guys to line up. That's close. Boom! I didn't kill anybody, though. Oh, no, it did. It just didn't actually get his head off. There we go. We got it. That's so funny. God, that move is so good. Yeah, I mean, like, perfect example, like the TAC ninjas compared with IS ninjas and the Fiend ninjas, it's ridiculous. Like, there's, I mean, these guys are like cheese compared to those. I mean, pretty much everything is when you have this move, but you know. Ooh, cheeky. I see you. Ah, you. Give me a health orb. Thank you. What's in here? Always just expect ghostfish. It's like whoever thought of that in NGB thought, hey, I've got an idea. Let's do that in every chest. Let's be a real arse about it. And put ghostfish in all of them. Load times, please. That looks like Kung Lao's forward 4-4. Where are you going? Oh, you stun locking little bastards. Come here. I got cheap stuff too. Oh, I love the teleport Izuna drops in the game. They're so cool. There's a test of valor on this too. Can't remember what it is. My memory on a lot of the test of valors is really bad. My memory on them for Master Ninja is pretty decent, but I don't remember what they are on the lower modes. No, don't ever try that shit. I love the forward X string, like in a corridor. It's so good. I just love that string in general, but in a corridor, you really get to see what makes it so strong. Cool. How am I doing for health? Oh, I got a couple of herbs out of this, so that's fine. I think I've got, what's it called, coming up? The mechs. Yep. There we go. That's one thing I always found amusing. When the game came out and some of the early reviews hit, a lot of people complained about the unavoidable quote explosions that hit you when enemies and bosses died. And I was like, I remember thinking that, like, all you've got to do is block. Like, they're not unavoidable at all. Just block. A class A ninja. I'm at least like S plus. Right, that takes care of you. Like that guy right there. All you gotta do is block, and like that won't hit you. I often wonder if that was kind of a conceit they made in the sequel. Like, even though on, you know, the high modes it will get you killed, you can just kind of button mash your way through normal and easy. And even on NGB, like if you were just mashing, you weren't really gonna do that well. Like, you had to actually play patient in that in the first game, like, no matter what difficulty you were on. Provided you are new to the game. You know, if you know what you're doing, you can kind of, you know, mess about. Yes, this way first. Because that's where I fight Genshin. Which is probably one of my favorite boss fights, actually. Wake up! Such a cool move. Nah, there we go. Controls are dead. hey, wise monkey. That name looks familiar. Are you on Test Your Might? That name definitely rings a bell. I think it's TYM. They just need to do a NGB remastered, man. Right, scythe time. Whoa, 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 whoa. Take care of you. And you. Let's have a little fun. Oh, I thought he was de-limbed. Oh! That looked really cool. Take that. Busy with Neo. Yeah, that's true. I mean, to be fair, I think the actual NG team is probably busy looking for a job after Devil's Third, but that's another story. No, not that string. Shit. Fucked up. Which one? Yeah, I thought so. I thought that name looked familiar. I'm usually fairly good at remembering stream names. Hello. What is with this frame rate? There's like three guys on the screen. Oh, I get it. You guys were hiding out, were you? This is also a pretty broken string. Just like YYY with the scythe. Really powerful. Like, it does one of the few strings that has like really, really high damage output and like insane OT properties and delimbing properties. I think like the first three hits of it pretty much all delim. Can't you guillotine throw guys into this laser? Remember Riley. Yes. Ah, that's so cool. The guillotine throw has got to be one of the most underrated moves in this game. It's so powerful. And in the first game, it was not useless, but not very, like, not all that great. Didn't really have a lot of, like, application. God, this frame rate is garbage. Yes, Ryu, attack the box. Yep, that box is real dangerous. Dumbass. There we go. Arrows, because it's... Do I have to charge up? Yeah. I think that's it. Yeah, I'm still holding out hope for an NG remaster. That's all I want. Just NGB in the Hurricane packs. Whoa, shit! Oh, that was a sick dodge. Come here. Boom. I love how that just puts you, like, you slide right under it. It looks so cool. Right, yeah, here's the lasers. But, yeah, just, I'd really love just NGB in the Hurricane packs, just in a download. That would be just, that'd make my day. It really would. Although, speaking of which, there is actually a mod floating around now for the original Xbox, where it actually enables you to launch the Hurricane pack separately. You have to have a original save on both packs. I won't like post any links to it because I don't want to. I don't want to deal with like distributing mods or something because I know there's all sorts of, you know, red tape about that. But yeah, they're out there. So if you've got saves, it's possible. You just need a modded Xbox. I don't know how easy it is. Yeah, they are. The animations in this game are top-notch. They are. They're really good. It's amazing how, like, even though Ryu moves in a way that doesn't... You know, it's obvious it's not a person, but, like, it looks like a person. Like, the animations look real. Like... Alright, well, that was not the one I wanted to hit, but... Like, I just, this, you know, it looks cool, the slow motion, but God, the frame rate is awful in this game. Nope. Take that. This ninja died in his sleep. What a scrub. Oh yeah, I have to go back down here now, don't I? Yeah, that's where I came. Oh, I do miss my roll. Oh no, yeah, there it is. But God, man, look at those talons. They look so sick. Wake up. That's such a good move. Oh, okay. Wise guys. There's a way to deal with you. I'm so glad that I have the voice not on English, because the stupid lines don't sound quite as dumb. Yeah, take that. Everything in here? Yeah. Oh no, yeah, it's this way, isn't it? I walked past this a lot too on my first time. Okay, monkey, no worries, man. I'll catch you later. Peace. Bats! Why can't you do, like, the proper strings on these? Look how much fucking health these things take. That was bats, man. Wait, Life of a Thousand Gods. Cool. Nah, you missed. Oh, you didn't miss that time. Legs. Face. Legs. Face again. Block low, son. I love that one. Oh, that's a good one too. Oh, wait, hang on. Isn't this where Piercing Void is? Yes, I remembered. Oh, okay, cool. I can't remember what that is. Man, it's getting a bit late. I don't know if I've got the energy to do a fiend challenge. I think I'll finish this chapter, and then I'll call it a night. There's still a lot of this game left. Load faster, please. Man, we've got some new people in the chat tonight. People, some that I don't recognize. Back to VHS is in. How's it going, dude? Mercenary, nice to see you again. Right, let's go. Cool. Why not? I think Ryu could, like, you know, quadruple wield Tonfa. He could put the other two on his feet. Whoa. You tried to be sneaky, didn't you? Tried to be sneaky. What kind of ninja are you? Using a machine gun. I think that's like the longest string in the game. Alright, let's take care of you. There we go. Where are you going? Damn it. Yeah, then you can Izuna drop. What is the notation on that string? Oh, yeah, that's it. XXX forward XXX. That's the one. XX. Oh, yeah, that XX towards YYY is really sick, too. Nah, son. You're headless. You lost your head, sir. Nope, I go down, don't I? I got plenty of health. Talons. Yeah, like, that's the string that I want to do, yeah. It's XX forward YYY. Great string. That's somewhat annoying in this game, though. Like, there was only really a couple of moves like that in the first game that, like, they looked really cool, but they were completely useless in terms of, like, actual, you know, combat. There's so many moves like that in this game that look absolutely amazing, but they're so, you know, there's just so much animation in them. You're so vulnerable. There's just never a reason to do them, even though they look amazing. Oh, yeah, I've got to do this first, haven't I? Can they actually hit me in here? Yes. So much for my really clever idea. Ah, you can't even hear though, can you? Oh no, yes you can. See, you gotta fight fire with fire. You gotta be just as cheap as the game. Would Ryu even be able to breathe, like, this high? I'm probably overthinking it, but... Oh, sweet, I've got max Nimpo supplies. Excuse me, lads. Coming through. There we go, that's the one I wanted. Die, please. Thank you. His friend is dead. No, he's not! See, he was trying to be sneaky. It's weird how the frame rate actually affects the inputs in the game, though. Like, your buffering window is enormous when the frame rate is low. Boom! There we go. God, such a good move. I mean, like, yeah, you're vulnerable in that, like, all the way through it. Like, there's hardly any there's invulnerability in the initial teleport, and that is it. I can't remember if it's TAC ninjas or IS ninjas here on Master Ninja. I think it is. I think it's IS ninjas. Which is what makes it, you know, a lot more difficult. I love the directional OTs. I wish more weapons had them. Doesn't the scythe have one? Oh yeah, it does. Ah, oh, that's so good. I thought I remembered that right. That side one is amazing. Is that... Yeah, that's where I came from. I imagine it'd be quite breezy in there. Come here. Not him. Oh. Alright. Are they both dead? Yeah. Let's do it again. Boom! Yeah! Oh, that's so good. Oh shit, I know what I need to do. Upgrade my piercing void. Have I not equipped my talisman either? No, I haven't. Oh, I'm really sad how much they just destroyed fire wheels in this game, too. Fireballs! Nope, what are you doing? Can't sneak up on me. I'll put wind blades back on for Genshin, though. any point upgrading? I mean, I can't buy anything else. Oh, incendiaries. I knew there was something I wanted to buy. I'm okay for arrows. Yeah, I got plenty of arrows. Screw this. I'm off. I'm out of here. Stop that. Oh, it's Genshin. Already. Ah, bloody grabs. Now, usually, like, in the smaller environments when you fight Genshin, jumping is, you know, pretty big no-no, but, like, you can kind of get away with it in this because you've got so much room to work with. And if you get lucky and actually catch him with an Izuna drop impact, it does a shitload of damage to him. Nah, get countered, son. Oh! Oh, I thought that was going to get him. Damn it, he interrupted me. That should take out... Oh, are you kidding me that I didn't get anybody? Yeah, look at that, man. I mean, like, that's a good chunk of damage. The OTs actually do have a hurt box too, which is nice. Like, the moves in the OTs can actually hit him. I think he has all his ninjas at once in the second time you fight him. God, that's so annoying. Not him. That was a very, very close. Right, he should be no problem now. Oh yeah. I like how he says Doria. That's cool. Oh, come on, he should be dead. There we go. Oh my, you've got to be kidding me. That's crashed again. And I didn't... Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, hey, VF. How's it going, dude? Oh, you've come in at a bad time, unfortunately. I don't believe that. The fucking... Jesus, man. When was the last time I saved? I saved pretty often, so I don't think I've actually got a whole lot left to redo on him, but that's annoying. That was a good Genshin fight too. Man. God damn this game. Like, God damn this game. That's why I don't play it, because it's buggy and it crashes and it's... God, this game is frustrating. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to hard reset here. Wow, can I not even, like... That was a very... I was really happy with that Genshin fight, too. Right, let's see how much I've got left to repair. You'll also get to see how long it takes me to actually... boot this thing. Yeah, I know a lot about the stuff with the hard drive, Ryu, but, like, the rest of the stuff on the hard drive is far more important to me than, you know, getting NG2 to be slightly less shit when it comes to performance. But there's no way I'm risking the other stuff that's on the hard drive just for that. Shouldn't it be an idea to have like a dedicated NG2 360 where you just have that installed and absolutely nothing else? Which, with how cheap 360s are, wouldn't actually be that, be that crazy to do. Yeah, I warn you guys, this takes a good minute or so to actually get to a point where I can play it. Takes a long time. That's my fault though for having Ninja Cinema turned on for like a good 2 years. I have like, I think, about 2,000 Ninja Cinema files. There we go. And now you get to watch loading again. It shouldn't be too bad though, as I've only just played it. It's when you first boot it up, like it takes forever. There we go. So whereabouts is that? Let's have a look. Oh, is the stream still live for you guys? I'm getting an error. I'm getting a rendering error message. Is it still okay? All right, guys, I just restarted the stream, so you might have to refresh. Right, how far back am I? Oops. Oh, I'm not that far back. Oh, thanks, Jones. Yeah, I'm back. I'm back live. Okay, yeah. God damn. Piece of shit. Right, this isn't that bad. I think I'm gonna do this again, but I'm gonna do it quick. Which means I ain't got time to kill you bitches. I don't need money. I'm out of here. And we got the old school costume on too. Old school means it's time for quickness. Ah, oh, you bitch. Oh, come on. Do I actually have to kill these? I'll just delim them. That doesn't delim them. Oh yeah, it does. Where was my frickin' OT then? There we go. Health, please. Thank you. This is basically. Oh no, I've only got to do a few fights. Yeah. Do I have to kill these guys? Whoa. Yeah, it looks like I have to kill these. It's a shame they don't do more with some of these enemies, because like some of them are, they just look very interesting. Hey, Costner's online. Right, yeah, can't be bothered, not doing you properly. Right, I'll actually kill the miniguns in front of Genshin this time and save at Genshin. Stop shooting me! Excuse me, lads. Coming through. Coming through. Coming through. This is why it's hard to speedrun this game. Because when you skip past fights, your frame rate goes into single digits.
Oh,
Excuse me, coming through. I really hope this doesn't crash again. I'm not in the mood for shenanigans. Nope. Open the door, Ryu, open the door. There we go. Not his fault though, I mean, the button inputs get dropped like crazy. Oh, do I have to kill these? Alright, well. God, look at this frame rate, man. Look at this frame rate, this is crazy. Hey, is that Zayrock? Am I saying that right? What's up, man? Yeah, it's been a while since I played NG. It's been a while since I streamed it. It's, it just, again, like everything, it's finding the time. Right, oh shit, no. I want to kill these. Because, I mean, that wasn't too bad. Like, I didn't really have to redo a whole lot. Climb the ladder. God, Ryu. Right, so now I should be able to use this save point. I mean, yeah, like, this is another aspect. Like, look at this. Like, this looks so rough in terms of graphics. Like, this looks like a first, like, a rough build, you know? This does not look like, you know, a finished level in a game. This looks like something you'd knock out, like, you know, to kind of show the basic layout of a level. This does not look finished. It's a shame, because the first game... I honestly think, in some aspects, the first game still looks better than this game. Which is crazy, because the first game was on the original Xbox. And yet, I still maintain that that's a good-looking game, even today. I still think that game looks good. I want my shurikens for this guy. Right, how many ninjas did he have? Was it about half a dozen? You bitch! He just opens up with a command grab. Yeah, how's that? I know there's a box here. What's in that? Why would they give you arrows in this fight? Oh, look at you. With just no leg. I always like to try and pronounce them right. Or at least how they're intended to be pronounced. Windblades! Wow, that did, like, all of nothing. Boom, boom! Where's your friends? There's one. Ooh, health orb. I'm getting spoiled. Yeah, it does. As I said, I mean, I've talked about it, like, a lot over the years, but it's just, it's really frustrating, because as I've always said, it's, when the game works properly, there is just nothing even close to this game when it works, but sadly, that is none too often. Oh yeah, his shurikens knock you back, don't they? Nah, I knew you were gonna do that. Oh, you bitch. Yeah, you didn't catch me that time, though, did you? Health orb. Thank you. Right. Swap over to the Genshin Slayer. Otherwise known as the Scythe. Oh, I didn't dash in time. The hitbox on this move is so dumb. Oh, he didn't dash. Boom! There we go. And now he runs away. He runs away. Oh, crap, I forgot about this guy. It's a good job I bought incendiaries. I completely forgot that you have to fight this guy after Genshin. You can OT this guy, though. Shoutouts to incendiaries. Because honestly, without them, this guy would actually be pretty damn hard. Like, if you couldn't incendiary him, he would not be an easy fight. Come on, give me my OT. There we go. Boom! Yeah, we missed the crash, man. This was another one. So many reviews had that listed as like, oh, you kill the boss and it's unblockable and you die. Like, hold block, you idiots. But I digress. Oh, yeah. 23 minutes without counting the crash. Thank you very much. Yeah, I skipped a load of kills that time, so no surprise that's not the higher rank. Well, the rankings are largely meaningless. They were in the first game, too. They're really trivial. What you actually have to fulfill to get Master Ninja is just completely stupid. Like, anybody could do it. Like, and they have. This is a good chapter. I do like this one. So I will look forward to coming back to this. Can't remember how this starts. But yeah, that is going to do it for this one, guys. Thanks for tuning in. Hope you all enjoyed it. It's always good to play some NG. And I will catch you guys again soon. I should be streaming tomorrow. I'll probably play a bit of Doom for sure. I'll play a bit more Doom. Maybe a bit of Halo. I'll see what I'm in the mood for. But okay.